Chapter 16, Sports in the Future, the four vantage points for initiating change come from working inside the organization, joining the opposition groups, creating new or alternative sports, and lastly, working outside sports. Being aware of our personal vantage point is important because each comes with its own constraints and opportunities for making sports what we want them to be. The first vantage point discussed is working inside sport organizations. Once an individual achieves a position of power within a sport organization, their views and goals tend to become more conservative. Even though said individual may favor certain reforms or transitional goals, their commitment tends to decrease as their position of power increases. This tends to be customary, however, it is not inevitable. On the other hand, by having an insider vantage point, it allows for individuals to have more information regarding the structure and culture of the organization. These individuals can then use their positions of power to influence change and create opportunities.
On Thursday, August 17th, Hurricane Harvey tore through the state of Texas. Its powerful storm left hundreds of thousands of Texans without power, food, water, and shelter. A few days later, Houston Texans player J.J. Watt took it upon himself to utilize his position of power to start a fundraiser for the victims of the storm. His initial goal was to raise $200,000, with $100,000 of it being his own money. Within 24 hours, his goal had been doubled, and nearly 3 weeks later, he had raised over $37 million. He and other athletes used their positions of power to influence others to help and donate, as well as creating opportunities regarding volunteering and helping pick up debris from the storm. This is a prime example of the first vantage point, which is within the system. J.J. Watt was able to use his power of position to help implement change and also influence and motivate others to do the same.
We put our words to action. Me and my man CP, we're out here, man. We're in it. You know, I'm just talking about we're actually in it with the people, right, handing out food, water, all needed materials, making sure that the money that was raised is actually being given to the people. With the Red Cross, handing out food as well. When I say that it's real, it's real. When I say that the love is real, the love is real. Shout out to my guy CP. Trevor Ariza out here with us as well. I'm just letting you guys see the words into actions. It's not just talk with me. The words get put into actions, man. Come out to touch the people. Love the people.
The vantage point of joining opposition groups is about that most change to sports are caused by groups that protest or oppose the norms of a sport and demand change to policies and programs. Some of these protests have included lobbying against stadium constructions that primarily suited the wealthy and privileged and believed that it was unfair to the whole community, especially when they're built on taxpayer dollars. The Olympics, on the other hand, and other mega events have also been strongly protested, but have not been effective. There should be progress in the future with this, as there's a huge sum of debt being put on the countries who host the venues. Other successful protests have included gender equity, building more communal sport venues such as skate parks and disc golf courses, and create more diverse sports that meet the needs of more people. Jerry Jones is the owner of the Dallas Cowboys. He has been notorious for not agreeing with the NFL commissioner and many others in placing a firm stance in his beliefs. Jerry Jones made the largest stride of his lifetime by being a part of the opposition group and for not wanting to use all taxpayer dollars to build the new Cowboy Stadium. AT&T Stadium is also coined as Jerry's World because he donated almost $500 million to fund the stadium. He fought for the state and local taxpayers to not hurt them in the process of the construction. Most importantly, Jerry Jones expressed that the stadium is to be used for hosting many soccer, college football, high school football, college basketball, and many other sporting events to give a place for all interests to come together. It's hoped to provide a state-of-the-art facility for the public to use. This goes against all trends in the past of stadium funding, and Jerry Jones became the first team owner to put a majority of his own personal funding into an organization for improvement.
Jones takes part in his 29th training camp as owner. Two accomplishments stand above all others. One occurred on the field, the other was the field. 2 weeks before the opening of AT&T Stadium, Jones sat alone on the 50-yard line of his $1.2 billion dream realized, tears falling onto the turf.
The night we opened, at the event that we had that we're referring to, I was getting me another touchdown down on that field.
I think there were tears of joy. I think there was probably some of, I wish my dad was here. I wish my mother were here to be a part of this. I know they would have loved to have seen what he accomplished.
When you've emptied your bucket, when you've gambled and you've got it, if you don't celebrate and get that feeling, then it won't be in you to go again, because you know you're fixing to go through some pretty painful times if you've taken.
The third vantage point, creating new or alternative sports. Creating new or alternative sports occurs when people reject dominant powers and social norms regarding sport performance. Although it is not easy to develop new sports, it is still able to with strong efforts and resources. Resisting a social norm of sports performance and creating new alternative sports then inspires the positive change of meaning, purpose, and organization of sport.
In the video you will watch next of the YMCA goes hand in hand with the section in the book, Creating New or Alternative Sports. Both are focused on accommodating the lesser privileged or less represented aspect of greater concept. The text is trying to support the idea of creating new alternative sports in a world driven by commercial sports that will provide creative changes in meaning, purpose, and organization of sports. While the video accomplishes the same kind of message using a different topic, it explains how the YMCA can be a factor that changes the success, drive, and relationship that may exist in the lives of unprivileged or forgotten kids.
I'm here. Can you see me? Because I feel like I'm invisible. Like this whole place is invisible. If it weren't for the nightly news, no one would even think of this place. But down here, things look different. Down here, our spirits are bright and our dreams are vivid. And if given a chance, that's what the world would see.
The fourth and final vantage point is working outside sports. In order to create the future of sports from an outside vantage point, this requires foresight and a grasp on how social change occurs. During the process, it encourages others to draft laws and create programs that provide equal opportunities for people with disabilities to participate in sports. Any organization or individual that works towards eliminating social injustice and puts effort towards creating opportunities for new voices to be expressed or heard is laying the groundwork for creating more humane and accessible sports in the future.
An example of the fourth and final vantage point of transforming culture and social relations is the creation of the Special Olympics. The Special Olympics was created so that individuals with physical and mental disabilities had the equal opportunity to participate in sports. With the creation of the Special Olympics, it allows for the athletes to continue to express themselves and to have their voices heard.
Special Olympics changed my life so much. Like friends, family, getting to know people, doing fun sports, it means a lot.
I think it's had a huge impact on their lives. They get an opportunity to meet other individuals that have disabilities like them. So it's an opportunity for all of us to come together and play sports and enjoy life.
Special Olympics means the world to me. Go, boys! I was bullied a lot in my life. When I first started Special Olympics, it was cool because I got to meet people that I can relate to and play with, and they will understand what I've been going through.
It taught me that it's okay to be different, which was hard for me to understand at first. I didn't have a very good middle school life or very good high school life. Lots of bullying. Now I'm comfortable with who I am and who I've become.
I think it shows them that their lives are valued and they're just as important as anyone else.